excited. Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. Now, I'm already kind of really on a upbeat today. Really on a kind of excited and really bouncy beat. Because I have just had two of the most glorious beers I've had for a long while. Just had a Windsor and Eaton Coronor Diamond. The kind of the celebrations of the Diamond Jubilee or Diamond Jubilee. Hold on. Pardon me. And I've just had a Stuart Brewery, Radical Road. Two glorious, glorious beers. And both of them Indy Parallels or India Parallels or IPAs or whatever you want to call them. One called itself an Indies Parallel, the other one called itself an Triple Opt Parallel. So I don't know if it, I don't suppose that means it's an IPA, I don't know. And this one is now one from America. As it happens, whereabouts in America is it from? Because I think I'll have this, yes, as one of my Wednesday Worldwide Beer Tour ones. And this is a Goose Island India Parallel from Chicago. That tunnel in town, Chicago. Oh, of course, all that funny writing, I hate that stuff. Cursive, I think they call it, don't they? I curse at it when I see it. Because I'm dyslexic. I'll show you around. Bet your bottom dollar you lose the blues. In Chicago, the kind of town that Billy Sunday wouldn't shut down. Right, stop singing, you'll get arrested. Allergy advice, contains gluten. That's what most kind of grains do, barley, wheat, things like that. It's nice to see. A little bit of kind of a little bit of an ingredients and stuff and notes and whatever. It's good, you know. I keep moaning about getting an ingredient list put on beers and that, which would be nice, really would. But no one takes any notice as usual. Here we go. Right, this is Goose Island. Really lovely cap, I like that, little pretty goose there, looking like he's smiling, doing that with his eyes again, you know, that semi-crescent thing, denoting a happy goose. Oh, I ain't gonna get enough. Oh, I've just got another one. I've got bottle cap Jenga up there, I'll show you one day, before I put me in my big bag. Right. Oh, that smells lovely as well. I think I'm going to have a good night tonight. I'm being so happy tonight. I've just had three glorious beers. I might even do a McLager now. Just to bring the kind of level down a bit. Otherwise, I won't be able to get sleep. Right. Here we go. Have I got anything to hold back? No. Do you know what? Pour it in. There's not that much. There's a tiny little flicker of yeast still there, but it was such a small flicker, it's hardly taken the crystal off the beer. And I like the yeast in, so try it with it in. There we go. Lovely shiny golden colour there. Right, let's give it a swirl. Oh, carbonation, look, carbonation, very nice and light, like that. Still holding a nice head, looks like there might be a bit of wheat in the beer as well. Really lovely fruit bowl flavours and smells there. Really beautiful, lovely, punching sort of smells there, those kind of... I I don't know where, I mean, I know Amarillo is an American hop. I think Citra though is Citra New Zealand? Nelson Sorvin's New Zealand. I'm not sure where Citra's from. I don't think it matters anymore, does it? We've got airplanes and all sorts. But it smells a little bit citrusy. Almost galaxy. You're getting... See, I go off on these hops, and I sometimes I almost forget to explain that what the bloody hell they smell like, innit? I'm getting on here. I'm getting slightly peppery, but very peachy and nectariney notes on the nose. Oh, beautiful, big fruit bowl. I'm getting a very slight cherry note there. Almost a coriander as well there. Have a smell of wet coriander, because wet coriander turns up in quite a few different beers, just a tiny edge of it. So have a smell of that. Oh, that's lovely. Right, see if I can get the other notes now, the malty notes. Sometimes I've noticed with American beers, they're very concentrated, you know, they pay a lot of attention to those lovely fruity hops and that, which are delicious, big fruit bowl hops, but they seem to forget to balance it with the malts and that. And it really is glorious. Pardon me. But I'm not picking up... something slightly perfumed. Like a cardamom or something like that. Maybe almost a fennel. But I'm not picking up much kind of malt-wise. There's a slight rich tea biscuit. And newly baked bread. But it's kind of, it's not showing the big caramel malts and the big kind of crystal malts and things like that. And right into the dark malts and that, you know. Yeah, there may be a crystal malt or something as well in there, something like that. Right, chin chin, bottoms up, cheers. Oh, that's lovely. Oh wow, that's lovely. That really is. That's just a hop bomb of lovely, you know, it's just a hop bomb of lovely fruity notes. It's like being whacked in the face with a sock full of fruits and mixed fruits and that, you know. Slap, get on that, you know. That is a shotgun full of fruits and stuff. Oh, that's lovely. Does it say anything? Blah, 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 blah. Oh, spicy. Yeah, I've got the spice. What else we got? Fruity flavour. Don't tell you where we're going with the fruits. That is... glorious. Right, before I finish that off, Goose Island, you buy it and try it. You definitely buy it and try it. Chicago. That is beautiful. That really is beautiful. Cheers, Goose Island. Cheers, America. Howdy! Oh, dear me. What am I like? Right, cheers. Bottoms up. Bye. Cheers.